Tell me, what does the name Marvin Lee a Day mean to you? Would it help you to pin it down if I told you that he's one of the biggest personalities in show business and has been for 30 years? He's got one of the most dedicated fan bases in the world, of which I am a proud member, along with a very credible acting CV and one of the most successful albums in music history to his name.
From New York City!
But what is his name? I hear you cry.
Meatloaf!
Okay, so his music may not be everyone's cup of gravy, but his life has been jam-packed with interesting stuff. So, now I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know about Meatloaf, from the famous singer he had a fight with, to a chance encounter with one of the most infamous men of last century, through to his rise to fame and fall from grace, and how he's achieved as great a cult status nowadays as anyone in the business. Meatloaf was born in Dallas, Texas, probably 59 years ago, although he's never been consistent when telling people his age. He was nicknamed Meat by his alcoholic policeman father when he was two, although, again, there's a couple of different stories he gives for the origin of his nickname.
I've been called Meat since I was 9 months old. You don't want to know why.
Despite being a tour de force personality, he has been known to rub the odd person up the wrong way, and he helped the infamous serial killer Charles Manson in his career. Well, he picked him up as a hitchhiker before he became infamous, but allegedly, blows were exchanged after he and Pavarotti argued over who would sing the climax during a duet. He also had a bust-up with K.D. Lang after she accused Meatloaf, who was a vegetarian for 15 years, of being a disloyal veggie by using that name. He renounced his vegetarianism, and his favourite meat these days is pork chops.
There's a peace waiting for you when you've never even gotten a taste. It's later than you think, and a kiss is a terrible thing.
He started fronting bands in his early 20s, but they never really got anywhere, so he pursued a career in acting while doing meaningless jobs on the way. Whilst working as a car park attendant, he got offered an audition for the lead role in Hair. He won. After doing Hair in LA, Meat recorded a minor duet album for Motown, but things didn't work out between him and the legendary production company, so he continued doing Hair. His first appearance in the limelight came when he played Eddie, a rock and roll rebel whose brains are used to create another man, in the Rocky Horror Picture Show, which has possibly the greatest cult following of any movie. After this, Meatloaf decided to put a hold on acting and concentrate on launching a music career. He and lyricist Jim Steinman went to work on what would become the biggest selling debut album of all time. You guessed it, Bat Out of Hell. Despite taking 2 years to get signed with this album, which was like nothing that anybody had ever heard before, dubbed Wagnerian Rock by Steinman, it sold around 34 million copies worldwide and remained in the UK charts for 474 weeks. It's never once exited the top 200 in the UK album chart, still selling 200,000 copies a year, making it the longest stay in any chart in the world. And according to the Recording Industry Association of America in October 2003, it's the 6th highest selling album ever. With his distinctive operatic rock voice and the success of Bat Out of Hell, Meat was finally basking in the public adoration he always felt he deserved. But as the 70s drew to a close, Meatloaf's unique voice started to fade, he and Steinman grew apart, and he became a suicidal cocaine addict. The 80s brought Meatloaf a monumental decline in reputation and acclaim, as he was declared bankrupt and descended into a phase of drug abuse and forgettable albums. Not that he was ever completely out of the public eye.
And just because you don't see me from time to time, it doesn't mean that I'm not working, because I work for 33 years. That's all I do.
He toured minor venues across the world throughout the 80s, building up a dedicated fan base, and when the 90s came around, he had regained a substantial amount of popularity, but still wasn't achieving much in a commercial capacity. Meat and Steinman decided that the time was right to make Bat Out of Hell 2 back into hell. It was released in 93 and became hailed as the biggest musical comeback in history, selling 20 million copies. The signature track from this album, I Would Do Anything For Love, But I Won't Do That, was number one in the UK for 7 weeks and easily became the highest selling single that year.
But I'll never forget the way you feel right now. Oh no, no way. And I would do anything for love.
Back Into Hell stayed atop the album chart for several months, along with a re-release of Bat Out of Hell. The follow-up album, Welcome to the Neighbourhood, also provided Meat with an epic number two hit single, I'd Lie for You and That's the Truth, which has, in my opinion at least, the greatest music video ever. Meatloaf has enjoyed giving music a backseat to act a little again, most recognisably in the serious role of cancer patient Bob Paulson in Fight Club.
Have you heard about the guy that invented this thing? He's a great man. Do you know about Tyler Durden?
He collapsed on stage during his final tour at Wembley Arena in November 2003, but was allowed to finish the tour. On Halloween this year, Meat released the much-anticipated Bat Out of Hell 3, The Monster Is Loose, which has received very mixed reviews, although just the fact that it's been released automatically makes Bat Out of Hell history's biggest music franchise. The first single to be released from it, Jim Steinman's It's All Coming Back to Me Now, which had previously been a hit for Celine Dion, reached number 3.
I own this song.
Good.
This is the damn definitive version of it.
But when you touch me like this,
touch me like
and you
this,
hold me like that,
hold me like
I
that,
just have to admit that it's all coming back to me.
His next single, my favourite since I'd Lie For You, is called Blind As A Bat and will be out on December the 18th. You can currently see Meatloaf in cinemas playing Jack Black's father in Tenacious D, The Pick of Destiny.
Been like a sinner before the gates of heaven, I'll come crawling on back to you.